G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. Got a little bit excited when I saw this little fella coming out from Alpine Miniatures, the US machine gunner, Winter. And as you know, if you're a bit of a modeler, there's plenty and plenty of German machine gunners out there with, you know, whatever, MG42s in 135, 116th, even maybe 130 MG34 and 1/9 scale. I don't know. Oh yeah, there is an MG34, MG42 guy in one. I think Kieran did one, and John Rosengrant's done two or three or something like that, in a number of different scales, maybe even more than that. But anyway, this one's about Alpine Miniatures, and I got very excited when it was a US figure, and I mean, doesn't he just look lovely there? Always get the two heads with Alpine Miniatures figures, unless you're getting the Vallejo paint set that I've reviewed. Just one head in those ones. Oops, I'm sure you saw it, but there's the number for it up the top there. And they also have it down the bottom. There you go, there as well. There is obviously another figure that you can get in the dual set, which is right there. If you're interested in getting both of them at once, it can obviously be a little bit cheaper if you buy the two together. I actually like this guy so much, I actually bought two of him. So that's why I didn't buy the set. I'll probably pick up this guy a little bit later, but I put two of this guy because I just thought he looked absolutely fantastic. There's the other guy there. And that's his code there, if you're interested in picking him up as well. He's really nice, but as you guys know, if you watch my channel, I am a bit of a sucker for a machine gunner. So I end up picking up about two of those to start off with. Here are all the parts laid out. Seven parts all up. As usual, we'll check out the actual main part of the figure first. Turn around like this, and then we'll zoom in a little bit closer. And as I'm sure if you've watched my channel long enough, you know I'm kind of in love with Alpine Miniatures figures. Mainly because they have very little casting issues and mold lines or seam lines on the figures, so they're very quick to clean up before you actually get into painting them. Some of the 3D printed kits, you've got to spend a lot of time cleaning those little fellas up before you get into painting them, but these don't take much time at all. So that's pretty much as close as I can get, but I think that's pretty close, especially if you're looking at it on a computer screen or TV screen. Bit of flash just down there, very thin, obviously you can see it. Boots are done nicely. A little bit of a mold line down the side there, you can see, so you have to clean that up just a little bit. A little bit of just excess. Resin just there on the side. So as you can see, it's pretty easy to clean up. Just a quick bit of the scalpel blade. Don't normally get that though, so that's very rare that I've picked up on Alpine Miniatures figure. The other side, this side here, is very nice and neat. Around the back. I didn't even notice that you actually got this little backpack or bag on the back of him there. Belt's done extremely well. Really detailed for 135 scale. I mean, look at the helmet there. As I always say, you're getting so spoilt in 135 scale. Years ago, you wouldn't even get that sort of detail on a 116 scale figure. Wow. Again, you can just see his eyeballs in there. So the eyes always helps when you have that, when you're just trying to paint the actual face itself. Here's the other one here, the other head. Yeah, and I didn't notice you sort of had the little beady underneath. Did you get that on the other one? Yeah, that's interesting. Normally the heads are very similar, but that's interesting because let's look at all. That's interesting because that head, you know, you normally have got a little beady under that one. I wonder if that's... Just shows up more on that head, on this one. That's interesting. Sorry, guys, but that was surprising to me. I almost think. Anyway, there you go. You want to take around the head? Really, not much cleanup. Some of them I've showed you before, you do get a bit more of a seam line up the back, but this one's almost not even noticeable on this head. Really like the little sort of beanie or whatever it is underneath, going underneath. It gives it a little bit more colour. Quite like that. And I mean, who doesn't love a machine gun? Look at that. If we whack this in for a second, you know how I like to do it, guys, just cheap and nasty. We'll put that there for a second. Got a crack. Something like that. Have a little bit of a close look at this little fella. I don't know if it'll show up there, but you see even in the end it's sort of hollowed out a bit, which is nice. You get the little grooves in it. The front, the other side, just show that just for the... Obviously that's resting against the body, so you're not really going to see that too much, but you've got the little joining marks for the where the wrists are for the little hands to go in there, which is a nice touch. But I mean, arm there, and his canteen or water bottle, whatever you want to call it. And oh, it's nice you get the actual US symbol on his little holster there. Sometimes you don't get them on some things, so that's nice. I think it's US. Very tiny. Hopefully it'll show up there. Put the out of focus somewhere. Makes it a hell of a lot easier to paint if it's actually sculpted on. And you've got the little strap coming down there for the machine gun on the inside. Really happy that they've actually done a... I'm sure there are a lot of people out there. There's always people complaining about, you know, Germans all the time. If you're a modeler, you've probably read them in the forums. Even though someone does a great sculpt of a German figure, you always get the people complaining about, you know, not another German, blah, blah, blah. But as long as it's a good sculpt and it looks fantastic, I don't mind whether it's a German or a US figure or a Russian figure. I'm more interested in what the actual figure looks like and the pose and the sculpting. And I really like this one. I can see this one be seen in a lot of little dios or vignettes in the future. Very nice little figure from Alpine Miniatures. As always, guys, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you later.